Children, we are discussing the first chapter, that is crop production and management. In this, we had already discussed about the first agricultural practices, that is how we prepare the soil by plowing and leveling. The second step which we had discussed already is selection and sowing of seeds. Now, bache, we are discussing the replenishment of nutrients in the soil, that how we increase the amount of nutrients in the soil which was taken by the crop plants. Crop plants has taken the nutrients from the soil bache to grow. So the nutrient deficiency will take place. In that we have discussed about the manures and fertilizers. In this video, we'll discuss advantages of manure and what are the disadvantages of fertilizers. What we have to choose, what we have to prefer among the manure and fertilizer are manures. Because manure do not cause any harm to the soil as well as to the environment. But fertilizers pose certain harms, certain, you know, consequences of use of fertilizers are there. Bachcho, manure better hai fertilizers se. Fertilizers pollution karte hai bachche. Soil ko harm karte hai. Lekin manure ka koi harm nahi hai. First bachche, the advantage of manure is manure increases the water holding capacity of the soil. The capacity, the ability of the soil to hold the water increases if we use manure. Manure increases the water absorption capacity of the soil as well. Next, they will make the soil more porous. Porous matlab usse bache porous banati usme chhed usse khol deti hai, usse open up kar deti hai, usse loosen kar deti hai. ताकि बेटा पानी जो है वो अच्छे से सीप इन हो सके, फर्टिलाइजर्स जो है, मिनरल्स जो है वो पानी के साथ डिसॉल्व होकर रूट्स को मिल सके. तो इट विल मेक द सोइल पोरस. ड्यू टू पोर्स, ड्यू टू सर्टेन गैप्स, द गैसियस एक्सचेंज आल्सो इंक्रीज. द रूट्स विल टेक ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द सोइल एंड रिलीजेस इट्स वेस्ट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इनटू द सोइल डायरेक्टली. दिस गैसियस एक्सचेंज इंक्रीजेस व्हेन वी ऐड मैन्योर टू द सोइल. नेक्स्ट, it increases the number of soil friendly microbes. Why? Because bache, the loosened soil will support the microbes. The soil hogi bache jo loosened hai wo support karegi bache microorganisms ki growth ko. Microorganisms ko jagah de payegi badi aasani se aur microorganisms ki growth badh jayegi. Next, it improves the texture of the soil. Isse soil ka jo texture hai wo bhi improve ho jayega. Soil जो है उसकी जो क्वालिटी है वो इंप्रूव हो जाएगी. नेक्स्ट, इन सेवेंथ क्लास यू मस्ट हैव स्टडीड द सोइल चैप्टर बच्चे. सोइल इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ सर्टेन पार्टिकल्स एज वेल एज सोइल हैज एन ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल एंड दैट ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल इज नोन एज ह्यूमस. इफ समवन आस्क्स यू व्हाट इज ह्यूमस, द ऑर्गेनिक कंटेंट, द ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल प्रेजेंट इन द सोइल इज नोन एज ह्यूमस ऑफ द सोइल. मैन्योर add the humus to the soil, whereas fertilizers do not add humus. Fertilizers किसी तरह का organic content add नहीं करते हैं बच्चे. Manure provide each and every kind of nutrient, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, सब कुछ थोड़ा थोड़ा करते हैं. But fertilizers are nutrient specific. वो एक अगर हम nitrogenous fertilizer use कर रहे हैं तो nitrogen ही provide करेंगे. अगर हम phosphatic fertilizer use कर रहे हैं तो सिर्फ phosphorus provide करेंगे. But manure का provide all the three kind of nutrients. Next, they are not expensive, they are economical. You can write here, economical is better. Means, har koi afford kar sakta hai bache. Dusra, it can be prepared from the wastes in the farm. Jo bache, farms mein waste hota hai, agricultural waste, usse use karke compost banai ja rahi hai, manure banaya ja raha hai bache. To hum waste ko bhi properly manage kar pa rahe hai, aur ye expensive too. Next, it does not cause water pollution, whereas fertilizers cause water pollution. That we will study. Manure koi water pollution nahin karte. So these are the advantages of use of manure. They make the soil porous. They increases the amount of soil friendly microorganisms. They make the soil porous, which helps in the gaseous exchange. They make the texture of the soil better. They are, you know, not very expensive. They are economical. And add humus to the soil. These are the advantages of the use of manure. Next, we'll discuss disadvantages of fertilizers. They cause pollution. The first is water pollution. Fertilizers are highly or readily soluble in water. बच्चे बड़ी जल्दी तुरंत घुल जाते हैं fertilizers. When they readily dissolves in water, then along with that water, the fertilizers will goes into the groundwater. They will seep into the groundwater. तो groundwater में जाएंगे बच्चे. Groundwater में chemical add होगा और groundwater की quality degrade हो जाएगी, decrease हो जाएगी. Next, through irrigation also, rainfall also, the excessive fertilizers are washed off. जब हम बच्चे पानी लगा रहे हैं एक्स्ट्रा इरिगेशन कर रहे हैं जब बारिश आ रही है बच्चे जितने भी हमने फर्टिलाइजर यूज किए कुछ तो प्लांट्स ने ले लिए बाकी सब क्या है एक्सेस में दोज आर वॉश्ड ऑफ एंड विल मिक्स्ड विद द वाटर बॉडीज लाइक रिवर्स एंड लेक्स एंड देन फर्टिलाइजर्स आर एडेड टू दोज रिवर्स लेक्स दैट विल कॉज वाटर पॉल्यूशन That water pollution may harm the aquatic organisms, the fishes, the organisms which are lying inside the rivers and the lakes. They will be harmed. The fertilizers will go into their body and pose harm to them, pose threat to their life. Next, soil pollution. Fertilizers are non-biodegradable. Bio means life, means living organisms. Degrade means which can be decomposed, which can be converted into non-poisonous substances. There are two kind of wastes, bache. Do tarah ke hote hain waste. Ek biodegradable aur ek non-biodegradable. Biodegradable wastes are those wastes which can be converted into non-poisonous substances. Whereas, non-biodegradable wastes, non-biodegradable materials are those which cannot be degraded, which cannot be decomposed into simple material. तो एक बार फर्टिलाइजर जो बन गए एज इट इज रहेंगे उन्हें माइक्रोऑर्गेनिज्म डिग्रेड नहीं कर सकते तो दे आर नॉन बायोडिग्रेडेबल व्हेन दे आर एडेड टू द सोइल दे विल रिमेन इन द सोइल फॉर लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम एंड कॉज सोइल पोल्यूशन और क्या कॉज करेंगे सोइल पोल्यूशन करेंगे नेक्स्ट सोइल इरोजन दैट पॉइंट इज नॉट रिटन इन योर बुक दैट इज फ्रॉम योर क्लास 9th बुक सोइल इरोजन इज फर्टिलाइजर्स विल मेक द सोइल पाउडरी जो फर्टिलाइजर्स हैं बच्चे वो सोयल को क्या करते हैं पाउडरी बनाते हैं पाउडर फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट कर देते हैं अब पाउडर फॉर्म होगी तो सोयल की जो अपर फर्टाइल लेयर है वो जल्दी से ग्लो हो जाएगी है ना सोयल अगर मोटी है तो रिमूव नहीं होगी अगर उसे पाउडरी बना दिया गया हल्की सी हवा चलेगी इट विल ब्लोन अवे एंड बैरन लैंड अपीयर्स और बंजर भूमि बैरन लैंड आ जाएगी दिस इज नोन एज सोयल इरोजन फर्टिलाइजर्स मेक्स द सोयल मोर पाउडरी They convert the soil into powdered form and thus causes soil erosion, thus increases soil erosion. So these are the harmful effects of uses of fertilizers. Next we'll discuss the difference between manure and fertilizers. It's a very important difference, bache. That difference will come in the next class as well. We'll decide certain parameters on which we differentiate between fertilizers and manure. The first one is nature. On the basis of nature, the compounds are of two kinds. One is organic compounds and other one is inorganic compounds. The compounds which are made up of carbon and its derivatives are known as organic compounds. And manures are natural organic substances. They are usually composed of carbon and its derivatives. Whereas fertilizers which are synthesized in industries, which are synthesized in the factories, are inorganic salts, inorganic compounds. What are inorganic? The compounds other than carbon are known as inorganic. Next, preparation. Fertilizers are to be prepared in the factories, in the industries, whereas manures are to be prepared in the farms, in the open field areas by the decomposition of organic material, by the decomposition of human waste, animal excreta, agricultural waste. Next, humus. As we have discussed already, beta, fertilizers do not add any organic content to the soil. The fertilizers do not add any kind of humus to the soil. They do not perform humification. Whereas, manures add the amount of or add a lot of amount of humus to the soil. They humify the soil. They increases the organic content of the soil, which increases the richness of the fertility of the soil. The next is coast. Fertilizers are costly, whereas manures are inexpensive. They are not very expensive, they are cheap, they are economical. Everybody can easily afford it. The next, amount of nutrients present. Fertilizers are rich in nutrients. If we are using nitrogen fertilizers, they are rich in nitrogen. If we are using phosphatic fertilizers, they are rich in phosphorus. If we are using potassic fertilizers, they are rich in potassium. If we are using complex fertilizers, they are rich in more than one kind of nutrients, like nitrogen and phosphorus, phosphorus and potassium, like this. Whereas manure contain less amount of nutrients as compared to fertilizers. Manures jo hai bache, unke andar jo amount of nutrients hoti hai, wo kam hoti hai. Inke andar hote sabhi nutrients hai thode thode. But as compared to fertilizers, the amount of nutrients is less. The examples of fertilizers is urea, potash, ammonium sulfate, ammonium nitrate, sodium nitrate, like this. Whereas the example of manure is compost, sun hemp, suspenia, dhencha, all these are included in manure. Some are green manure and other ones are the compost. So that is the difference between fertilizers and manure. You can add one more difference also. That is the amount required. Fertilizers are required in small amounts, whereas manures are required in bulk. Fertilizers badi amount mein nahi chahiye bache, thodi amount mein chahiye. Whereas manures are required in bulk. They are required in large amount. You can add that point in this difference bache. Next, solubility also. The last difference is solubility. Fertilizers are soluble in water. They are readily soluble in water. Badi aasani se ghul jayenge bache paani mein. Whereas manures are insoluble in water. Manure jo hote hain wo insoluble hote hain bache. Paani mein jaldi se ghulte nahi hain. So that is the difference between fertilizers and manure. Next, we'll discuss the next step of agricultural practices, that is irrigation. We know bache, water is required by the plants. 90% of the plant's composition is composed of water. Plants ka 90% hissa kis cheez ka bana hua bache, paani ka. Also, plants absorb the nutrients from the soil, and those nutrients are present in the dissolved form or the soluble form in the water. So, for all these things, water are required. But the rains are not very consistent every place. So, other than rain, we require certain methods by which we can provide water at regular intervals to the crop field, to the crops. And that process is known as irrigation. The supply of water to the crop plants at regular intervals, at constant intervals, through sources other than water, through resources other than water, is known as irrigation. बच्चे एक regular interval के बाद crop field को, crop plants को पानी provide करना rain के अलावा, इसे क्या कहते हैं? Irrigation कहते हैं. Now we'll discuss why we require water. What is the advantage to crops by providing it water? Why water is necessary for the crop plants? First is, water is required for the proper growth and development of the plant parts like flowers, fruits and seeds. Without water, the germination of seeds do not take place. In class 6, you must have done the activity of germination of sprouted seeds. उसमें बच्चे आप क्या करते थे? Green gram लेते थे, उसे पानी में भिगो कर रखते थे एक पूरी रात के लिए. 12 hours or 24 hours at least. Then उसे बच्चे बाहर निकाल कर एक cotton cloth में spread कर देते थे, shade में रख देते थे, उसमें से white color का एक thread-like structure निकल आता था, उसे sprouts कहते थे. That is germinated seed बेटा. The seeds got germinated. उग गया हो, उसे अंकुरित बीज बोलते हैं, जो उग गया हो. तो water is essential for the proper growth and development of the plant parts like fruits, flowers, seeds, as well as it is required by the plants for the germination of seeds. Next, plants absorb the water through roots, and by that they also absorb the minerals and nutrients in the form of fertilizers. पानी में घुले हुए हैं बच्चे, तो जब पानी absorb करेगी roots, तो पानी के साथ वो भी plants के अंदर आ जाएगा. Next, water is essential for photosynthesis, as water is a raw material for photosynthesis. Photosynthesis के लिए जो raw material है, जो कच्चा माल है, वो water है. तो उसके बिना प्लांट फोटोसिंथेसिस परफॉर्म नहीं करेगा, फोटोसिंथेसिस परफॉर्म नहीं करेगा तो प्लांट मर जाएगा. Next. Water dissolves nutrients in it and then transport those nutrients to each and every part of the plant body. What these nutrients do?
Growth and development.
Next. Water protects the plants from the frost and hot currents. उन दोनों चीजों से बचाने का काम कौन करता है?
Water करता है.
Now, at what time we provide water? How many times we provide water? That is known as the time and the frequency of irrigation. किस समय पर पानी देना है बच्चे और कितनी बार पानी देना है? That is known as time and frequency of irrigation. And time and frequency of irrigation or applying water, providing water to the crop plant depends on three factors. कब पानी देना है और कितनी बार पानी देना है ये तीन फैक्टर्स पे डिपेंड करता है. The first is nature of the crop plants or crop based irrigation. सबसे पहली चीज हम देखेंगे बच्चे क्रॉप कौन सी है. Every crop has its different water requirements. For example, rice require continuously standing water, whereas wheat and cotton do not require water that much. बच्चे wheat और cotton को बस पूरे सीजन में दो तीन बार पानी लगाना पड़ता है और जबकि rice को continuously standing water चाहिए तो उसकी जो बच्चे time और frequency है वो जल्दी आएगी. Rice को जल्दी जल्दी पानी लगाना पड़ेगा जबकि wheat और cotton के केस में ऐसा नहीं है. The next is nature of the soil or soil based irrigation. Various kinds of soils are there like sandy soil, clay soil, loamy soil. Sandy soil do not have the water holding capacity. It has large particles, it has large pores, so water will seep in. So the frequency of providing water in the sandy soil is quite high. Sandy soil ko bar bar pani dena padega bache. Whereas the clay soil holds the water. उसके बीच में गैप बहुत कम होता है, पानी को पकड़े रखती है तो पानी नीचे जाता ही नीचे नहीं जाएगा बच्चे, तो सोयल मॉइस्ट रहेगी तो क्ले सोयल में ज्यादा पानी देने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती. नेक्स्ट, सीजन व्हेन द क्रॉप ग्रोज और सीजन बेस्ड इरिगेशन. फॉर एग्जांपल देयर इज अ मॉनसून सीजन, व्हेन मॉनसून रेन्स कम्स ऑफनली, तो बच्चे बार बार जब रेन ही आ रही है हमें पानी क्यों निकालना ग्राउंड से. द अदर सीजन इज नॉन मॉनसून, जब इतनी ज्यादा रेंज अवेलेबल नहीं है, जब रेंज अवेलेबल नहीं है बच्चे तो पानी अवेलेबल नहीं है तो हमें बार बार पानी देना पड़ेगा. सो ऑन दिस बेसिस वी डिफरेंशिएट दैट हाउ द टाइम एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी, दैट इज व्हेन एंड हाउ मेनी टाइम्स द वाटर इज टू बी गिवन टू द क्रॉप प्लांट्स. द वन इज क्रॉप बेस्ड इरिगेशन, वी डिसाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ टाइप ऑफ क्रॉप. सेकेंड, सॉयल बेस्ड इरिगेशन, वी डिसाइड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ टाइप ऑफ सॉयल, फॉर्म ऑफ सॉयल प्रेजेंट इन दैट गिवन रीजन. एंड द थर्ड, द nature based, season based irrigation. We decide on the basis of season of that particular area. Next we'll discuss the methods of irrigation, how we can give the water to the crop plants. There are two methods of irrigation bache. The first one is traditional method which we are using from the old times. Another one is modern method. In traditional method, there are different examples of traditional method are moat, pulley system, chain pump system, dhekli and rahat. In these systems, the small wells will be there, the small pools are there where water level is quite up. Nowadays, that is not present that much in our country. And we use the cattles, the buffaloes or the bullocks, or the human labor to withdraw the water from those and then to put that water, to spread that water in the fields. This is very laborious method. It is very cheaper method, but it is very less efficient and a lot of labor is required for that. Whereas the modern methods in which that two we discussed, other than that there are other systems as well, like canal system is there, tube well system is there, submersible pump system is there, bache. But that is not the part of your syllabus that you will study in your class 9th. But the two systems which are in your book is drip method or sprinkler system. First is drip system or drip method. In this, pipes are to be placed or spread in the crop fields. These pipes have holes at particular interval. From those holes, the water will seep out and water will directly pour over the roots. इन होल से बच्चे पानी डायरेक्टली रूट्स पर पड़ता है, रूट्स डायरेक्टली पानी को अब्सॉर्ब कर लेती हैं और कोई इवेपोरेशन की फॉर्म में वाटर लॉस नहीं होता. इट्स अ वेरी इफेक्टिव मेथड इन प्रिवेंटिंग द वाटर लॉस बाय इवेपोरेशन. द अदर मेथड इज स्प्रिंकलर सिस्टम. इन दिस अ मेजर पाइप इज देयर ओवर विच द वर्टिकल पाइप्स विद द मूविंग नोजल्स आर देयर नोन एज स्प्रिंकलर्स. These are known as sprinklers. In the diagram, it appears that they are very closer to each other, but they are not that much closer. It's just a diagrammatic representation, a rough diagrammatic representation of it. These sprinkles have nozzles fitted it, over it. These nozzles rotate due to Newton's third law that you will study in 9th class. And then the change in the direction of water sprinkling is there. The water is sprinkled over the leaves, and that's how we provide the water to the crop plants. So that's the sprinkler method. These two methods are very effective in prevention of the water loss by evaporation. So these are the methods by which we provide water to the crop plants other than rains.